Hello, ladies and gentlemen. That always happens, too. All right, hello, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello.
And welcome to the, I'm guessing the first this year, Midnight Show.
Adam and His Old People Days.
Tentative title. We haven't thought of the title yet, but I'm Adam Balaban.
And I'm Justin McCarthy. I'm just coming in for tonight, maybe
an honored guest tonight who is in the music business himself. And we have a little intro music to begin with. From Justin.
Yep.
Yeah.
Is that in the right output? Phones?
Yeah, it is. That's loud. Alright, sorry about that. If anybody heard that, that was a low version of the intro provided by Justin McCarthy.
The funk shuffle, if you will. Shuffle. Even though it's not a shuffle, but...
I don't know. We'll try and work on that. Hopefully that doesn't do it with all the songs.
Yes, hopefully.
Yes. And if you like that, actually, by Justin, he has an album.
Yes.
And it's on sale.
For free.
For free, because...
Because my band's not together anymore.
Cool.
Yes, we're the Time Merchant.
So it's a collectible. Yeah.
Collectible, yes.
Because no
vintage.
One's, yeah.
Vintage 2010.
All right. So we're just going to play a few songs for the next hour, yeah? And we're going to start with basically... What this is an oldies station, pretty much. Of course, oldies being like 70s or 60s or anything before that. But I'm a big fan of the 80s, and so anything before that. But I don't want to leave the 90s out, of course. You don't want to leave the 90s out, right?
Of course not. Who would?
Yeah, the 90s were great. I love the 90s. From the 90s, actually.
Yep.
So, I'm still going to call it an oldies station, probably, even though it includes the 90s. So anything really before the year 2000... Music-wise.
20th century music.
Yes, which is another good title. But not really. Well, we'll get on. Anyway, the first song here is from 1954 by Bill Haley, although it's originally from 1952. Bill Haley and the Comets are the most successful version of it. And hopefully this goes better than the intro song. I'm sorry about.
That's okay.
Yeah, we'll get up there. Yeah. Okay, and... If any of you may recognize this song, or if you like this song, here's Rock Around the Clock.
One, two, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock.
How come that one's working?
Sorry about that rough start. Here we go.
Two, three, and four, if the band goes down, lose your four, we're gonna
That was Bill Haley and the Comets.
Yes, it was.
What did you think of that? Have you heard that song before?
I have. I hear you playing it from your room.
Yes, because I'm having a noise war with everyone.
It is quite the noise war.
Yes.
With Andy's sound system there.
And a great sound system it is, too.
You can't really compete with Katy Perry, though. I mean, when you blast Katy Perry, just...
Is she like, recently popular?
Of course.
Okay, because I don't follow, like, contemporary popular
Andy does.
Music. Well, clearly. Yeah. All right, then. I guess we're going to have to talk a little louder. I was told to keep it between the C and the A, and I'm not keeping it between the C and the A at all.
All right. We'll turn the mics up.
What?
Isn't that that always helps.
Isn't that the easiest solution, Justin? Okay, anyway, here we go. While we play along with the mics, we're going to go with the next song, which was originally from 1975, but it was made popular by Joan Jett and the Blackhearts in 1981. You know, you don't get that nowadays. You don't get a person's name and then the da-da-das. Everyone's just by themselves.
No, you don't.
No.
Frank Zappa and the Mothers.
Was that real?
Yes, that was the best example of that.
Okay, fine. All right. Guess I'll have to look them up now. Okay, anyway, so here's Joan Jett, I Love Rock and Roll, from 1981. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was I Love Rock and Roll by Joan Jett and the Blackhearts. What did you think of that?
It was very, very good.
Very good, yeah. Classic 80s. Here's another one from, here's another one from 1 year earlier from a group called Blondie, who I really love. This Blondie's probably my favorite band right now.
Really?
Sort of on a Blondie That's kick. I've been on a Blondie kick for about, like...
18 years.
No, probably one... 18 years. Wise guy. No, probably just 1 year. And here's... Alright, and here's a good song by Blondie. If any of you have ever seen the 80s movie American Gigolo, this was the theme. You ready?
Wait. Okay, I'm ready.
Okay, great. The wrong button there. All right, and we're back.
We are back.
I bet I'm going to say we are back after every single song.
I wouldn't doubt it, Adam.
Yeah, you wouldn't doubt. Okay. Next song I recently liked a lot, and it's from, have you ever heard of the movie Cool World?
I haven't.
You haven't?
No.
Well, it stars Brad Pitt and Kim Basinger, who, as you know, was in the first Batman movie.
I didn't know that, but I will accept it as a fact.
Good, because it is a fact.
All right.
Okay, anyway, it was a very, probably, if I had to say, unpopular Tale Boy the box office movie about a guy who drew cartoons while he was in prison, became successful, and then got sucked into his cartoon world.
That's interesting.
And it wasn't for kids. It was a very adult situations cartoon.
I have seen that, yes.
You have seen it?
I remember it.
You remember her dancing with the laser light show?
I thought of it as a really creepy version of Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
I love Who Framed... Actually, that's going to come up later on, but I love Who Framed Roger Rabbit, and I have that. I want to watch that with somebody on VHS.
I don't think anyone... I don't even think VHS exists anymore, Adam. I'm sorry to say that.
Well, I don't think you exist anymore. How about that?
All right, maybe we should move on.
Okay, anyway... Here is the song from Cool World that was actually more popular than the movie from 1992, which was also the year I was born. Did you know that?
I could have guessed it.
You could have guessed it.
That's the year I was born.
Do you want to guess what date?
I'm going to pass on that.
All right. I guess we'll find that out on a later show. Okay, anyway, here is Real Cool World by David Bowie. Every time I think I'm going to stop it, Beatles starts. So, we are back.
We are.
Told you I'd say it again. Alright, and that was Real Cool World. If anybody ever
wants...
That was
pretty cool.
That was pretty cool.
Real cool.
Are you saying that because of the name, or did you actually like it?
I'm not really sure yet.
Right. It's not a bad song, though. It's not the worst song in the world.
It's very 80s.
It's from 92.
It's still very 80s. A song can be from, like, the 60s and be very 80s.
I like you. You just got a great personality. Okay, anyway. I don't know. We'll do a little break before we get to Roger Rabbit. Alright, and here's another song that's very 80s because it's from 89. Alright, Paula Abdul in... This is where she... What's the name of the cat? Did you ever see this music video for this song?
No, I did not.
Alright, I think it's called MC Cat, but I'm not sure what the cartoon character is. No. Well, I guess it fits. It deals with cartoons. Okay? This is a cool music video if you ever see it, and the song is Opposites Attract. Listening twice. All right. Hello, and we're back.
Yes, we are.
I gotta stop saying that. Okay, anyway, real quick, I forgot about these. I just wanted to do a few ads out of the kindness of my heart. Just
the pure generosity.
I like these, and I think these are interesting. You know, Colt doesn't like the pumpkin contest.
Colt doesn't like anything.
He doesn't. It's very bitter.
He's got a Colt heart.
He's a...
Boom!
Colt is a very bitter creature. I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay, anyway, There is a, for those of you who don't know, there is a pumpkin carving and coloring contest.
Who doesn't love pumpkins?
I love pumpkins. I think I might do this, actually. I don't know about the coloring, but definitely the carving. Maybe. Again, drive to Walmart, pick up a pumpkin, start carving it in his Corvette.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, there's a pumpkin carving coloring contest held from October 25th through the 28th, and the winner will be announced on the 29th. And we'll receive $50 in points.
50 American dollars.
In points.
In points.
That's nothing to
say. So that's not really American dollars, is it?
It's no, but, you know.
You can buy like 10 candy bars from the C store.
You could buy Stewart's root beer from the coffee shop.
You could, yes. Technically.
And sushi. I think that's ridiculous. Sushi's not a meal. Anyway, off track. Also,
blasphemy.
The reporter who. The Reporter, which is our newspaper.
Wait. Reporter? I barely know her.
God.
Jesus. Boom!
You know, it's funny. I don't see any copies of it ever for sale.
Of what?
The Reporter. Well, like, maybe not for sale, but like, yeah.
I've never even heard it.
I know, but there's
maybe
always...
Maybe that's why it's not for sale.
There's always... Oh, what am I thinking about? It's right here. I'm such an idiot. It's right here. Their relaunch is on October 26th. That's why there hasn't been any newspapers. They haven't come out yet for the year. God. Why am I so stupid? Anyway, the point of this is that the Reporter is gearing up for its relaunch on October 26th, and they are looking for creative writing submissions to showcase student talent in the first issue. And this includes poet... Colt?
What? I said cool.
Oh, I thought you said cool. Okay. Cool world. And this includes poetry, short stories, comics, etc., and all sorts of other creative writings are welcome.
Adam, you should submit your stories.
I'm gonna try to. I'm writing a
Adam
story
here
right
is quite
now.
The he's quite the aspiring writer.
I'm trying to be. I'm writing a story right now that's another sort of creepy horror
story. Trying to be an aspiring writer. You're aspiring to be an aspiring writer, Adam.
Yes, exactly. Is that a double negative?
No, that's a double positive, but it just makes it...
Anyway, here, if you have any submissions, like poetry, short stories, comics, etc., please send them to jfoley@stetson.edu.
J. Foley.
J. Foley. Or mmoist@stetson.edu. mmoist@stetson.edu.
Ooh, moist. That's a nasty word.
I don't get it. It's probably the person's last name. What are you saying? It's a nasty word for it.
Moist is the most hated word in the English language. Look it up.
Okay, anyway, as Justin brought up earlier, Cool World is sort of, what did you call it?
A creepy version of Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
And Who Framed Roger Rabbit from 1988 is a very good movie, if any of you have ever seen it. And if any of you have ever heard of Jessica Rabbit, you will know... What song is probably coming up?
Yes.
And for those of you who don't know who Jessica Rabbit is or what she looks like, well, I'm sorry about that. Because she is really something to look at, isn't she?
If you like to look at cartoons, then she is.
Of course she's a cartoon. You have to look past the cartoon. She can't exist in real life. Her proportions are just too... proportionate. Okay, anyway.
I guess.
Anyway, we're getting off track here. Anyway, the song is originally from 1936, and it's a blues and jazz song, but it's Jessica Rabbit's version.
Mm.
And I think the
act, called?
I think the woman who sang for her voice was Amy Irvin.
Never heard of her.
I never heard of her either, but that's what Wikipedia said, and Wikipedia is all-knowing.
Always.
So here is Jessica Rabbit's version
of
Why Don't You Do Right. Some other man do. was Jessica Rabbit's version of Why Don't You Do Right.
Oh, yes it was.
How did that work?
Oops, that's not good. But, what's that?
How did that work?
It didn't work.
It didn't work?
The double pop filter doesn't work.
Okay. But well, it was worth a shot.
Yes. That was a good song. I like that song.
Yeah. I was surprised that was available for download.
Yep.
Yeah. I guess anything can be, though.
Yep.
All right.
Really like the double bass. Great. Upright bass.
Yeah, I like good the snaps. Right.
All right. Yes.
I used to hate not doing that, and then I like was able to snap my fingers like 6 years ago. I was so happy. Okay. 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 All right. So the next song is from 1985. You know, like right. I said, I love the 80s, so we've had a bunch of them. And then, don't worry, after this is a 60s song, I promise.
All right. Okay.
But here we are. By what?
I'll go after the next song.
You go after the next song? Okay.
The last song.
All right, the last song.
With me.
For Justin. All right. I already forgot. Oh, Tears for Fears. Tears for Fears, a great British rock band.
By whom?
Are they rock?
I don't know.
No, Tears for Fears is whom?
I have no idea.
Tears for Fears is whom?
I know.
It's not the song.
Oh, I don't know.
That's why I'm telling you. You haven't noticed I've been ending everything with the name of the song?
I don't know.
Okay.
Maybe we should just play it.
Anyway, here's Everybody Wants to Rule the World. And we're back.
We are back.
And Justin's leaving.
Yes, I have to go.
All right.
Yes. But I'd like to thank Sean for the beautiful picture that I just received on my phone.
Truly autistic.
That, what a piece of art.
Yes.
He is.
Yes.
And Colt, you are a good man, and I hope you're having fun playing Fallout, and, you know, stuff like that. Oh, I'm getting another text. But let's stay on the air and see what this is.
Mystery text.
Mystery text.
What could be in
Colt. The
mystery text.
Oh. Colt, that's beautiful. That's Jessica Rabbit. That's, man. Jessica Rabbit and her accessories, yes.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good band name, Jessica Rabbit and her accessories. That's okay. A beautiful band name.
All right. Well, it's been fun, Justin.
Yes, it has been fun. Thank you very much for having me on the show, Adam. And I will see you all over there in Carson in a few minutes. All
right. Have a safe trip back.
See you, Adam.
It was great having you in the studio.
Yep.
All right. Why does he keep texting you?
Because he hears me.
I know he hears you, but he's just a... Anyway, for our next song, we're going to kick it over to the swinging 60s, 1965. And here's the Beatles with Help.
Oh, this is the best song.
You want to stick around?
No.
Okay, now Justin's gone, so we can't have any playful banter. And, well, let's move on. Now we're going to 1982 with the Steve Miller Band. And those of you who know the Steve Miller Band know they did The Joker, which is a great song in itself, but we have a different song for you. We have Abracadabra. And that was Abracadabra, which is a great song. And it just occurred to me that theoretically if I had started 10 minutes earlier, I would only have like a little bit more to go right now. And I thought I wouldn't have enough songs, but having Justin here really helped out. So, actually, you know, theoretically, I couldn't play all these songs, but it's the first show. I'm going to go ahead and do it. So, here is our last long song. And to me, like 5 minutes is a long song. So, here is Iggy Pop from 1977. Great song, Lust for Life. That was Lust for Life. Now we have a song I'm sure a lot of you have heard before, and I'm sure a lot of you like it, from 1980 from the popular band Queen. Here's Another One Bites the Dust.
Down the street with the brim pool way down low. Ain't
That was Another One Bites the Dust by Queen. And we continue along with our good old-fashioned, well, not old-fashioned, but well, not really classic either. But we're continuing with our old songs from the 80s, 70s, 60s, 50s, so on. So here we go, all the way back to 1958, The Champs. This really is more like a instrumental song, but if you feel like dancing, this is a really good song to get moving to. Here is Tequila. And that's Tequila. And now we're jumping back up to 1984. Have we been there yet? No? Okay, here's our first song from 1984. Our only song from 1984. Kenny Loggins. And it's Footloose. And if any of you have ever seen the movie Footloose, it's a musical. Well, it is a musical now, but it was a movie originally. But it's a great song nonetheless. And if you're not moving to this song, you're dead. So here is Footloose from 1984. We'll be right back. right. Wasn't that a fun song, kids? Okay. So, we jump from 58 to 84, and now we're going back to 54 to a song that's early doo-wop. Here's the Crew Cuts with Shaboom.
You up in paradise up above. If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love, life could be a dream, sweetheart. Hello, hello again, shaboom, and hoping we'll meet again. Oh, life could be a dream if only all my precious plans would come true. If you would let me spend my whole life loving you, life could be a dream, sweetheart. Now every time I look at you, something is on my mind. Da, 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 da. If you do what I want you to, baby, we'd be so far. Oh, life could be a dream if I could take you up in paradise up above. If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love, life could be a dream, sweetheart. Shaboom, shaboom. Ya-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, shaboom, shaboom. Ya-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, shaboom, shaboom. Ya-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, shaboom. Shaboom, shaboom. Ya-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, shaboom, shaboom. Ya-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, shaboom, shaboom. Ya-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, shaboom. Baby, we'd be so fine. Life could be a dream if I could take you up in paradise up above. If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love, life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Hello, hello again, shaboom, and hoping we'll meet again, boom, shaboom.
Hey, da, dee, ding, dong, da, lang, da, lang, da, lang, shaboom, ba, do, ba, do, ba, do, ba, ba. Life could be a dream.
Life could be a dream, sweetheart. Life could be a dream if only all my precious plans would come true. If you would let me spend my whole life loving you,
life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Do you shaboom shaboom? Do you shaboom shaboom? Do you shaboom shaboom? Sweetheart.
There's a little song for you. Just a little blast from the past. Okay. If anybody else is listening, which a couple of you are, I can see, here are some announcements. Again, if you are interested, The Reporter, which is our newspaper, is gearing up for its relaunch on October 26th. They're looking for creative writing submissions to showcase student talent in the first issue. And this includes poetry, short stories, comics, etc. So please send your submissions to jfoley, J-F-O-L-E-Y, at stetson.edu, or mmoist, M-M-O-I-S-T, at stetson.edu. And also next week, from the 25th through the 28th, there will be a pumpkin carving coloring contest. And you have a chance to win $50 in points, which is nothing to sneeze at. $50 in points sounds great. And the winner will be announced on the 29th, after the contest is over. So, I hope you've enjoyed our show tonight, our first show, and our last song is going to be from 1965, from The Vogues. Here is one of my favorite songs, 5 O'Clock World.
Goes down the drain.
Yeah, yeah.
But
yeah.
It's a 5 o'clock world when the whistle
Ladies and gentlemen, that was the last song of the evening. I went from saying, you know, I went from saying we're back after every song to saying all right after every song. Okay, before Justin left, he wanted me to play a Led Zeppelin song, and he said it was very good. So, this is the end of the show. So, I'm just going to put it back onto the 24-hour song network we have here. So, here is a Led Zeppelin song, and if I'm saying it correctly, Braun E-R Stomp. Braun Y-R Stomp. Probably not saying that right, but here you go. All right. Good night, everybody. It was great playing music for you. Hope you enjoyed it.